Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Wednesday Rewind, where we talk about what we talked about. And this past Sunday, we preached through Psalm 33. What a fantastic psalm. I'm still being blessed by it as of this moment. And in this psalm, the psalmist does something very cool. But before I go there, let me ask you, do you have a favorite love song? You know what kind of song I'm talking about, the song that you have just between you and your beloved. Even if you have a song about for you and your friends or your kids, but there's a love song that's unique to you. Which one is yours? I met my wife in high school, so we have a specific one. I'm not going to tell you which one it is. That's going to stay between me and my wife. But here's what I bet. I bet that love song not only talks about how you feel about that person, but probably tells you why you feel that way. It probably serves as a descriptor of not only my love for that person, but what about that person causes me to feel the way I feel. What's awesome is that this psalm does just that. This psalmist actually invites us in to celebrate God. In fact, at the beginning, he says, sing a new song, and he talks about being loud. This isn't a quiet song. This isn't a song that Bob Dylan would sing just with his guitar and his harmonica. No. This is a stringed quartet, a symphony. This is Earth, Wind, and Fire, you dig, with the drums and the smoke machine and all of the horns. It's a big song. But then the psalmist talks about not only rejoicing in God, but he tells you why. And he gives us four divine characteristics of God throughout the psalm. The first one is that God's word is powerful, that when God says it, oh, it happens. And the psalmist kind of nods back at the creation narrative where God speaks life to the earth and it comes to be. Isn't it amazing? God says, let there be light, and the sun comes on as if you hit a light switch. God's word is powerful. God speaks through Isaiah and says that his word will not come back to him void, but accomplishes that which he sent. God's word is powerful. Are you in the word? Are you reading it? Are you believing, in fact, that God's word is powerful? The working in you and the working out through you, God's power through his word. The second thing that the psalm tells us is that God is in control. That no matter what happens, God is never abdicating his responsibility and his control and authority over the planet Earth. Mankind, check this out, mankind always, nation after nation, throughout the history of mankind, they always push to go towards that which is counter to God. But God started this whole thing by saying it's good. So man presses towards the antithesis of what God intended, but they cannot win because the plans of man do not usurp the purpose of God. God says he's in control, and no matter how squirrely it looks, God's divine will be done. Now that is a reason to rejoice. God is in control. The psalmist also invites us to see that God sees all. In fact, he talks about how he looks from his high position down on mankind and he beholds all of the inhabitants. Not only what they do, but what they think and what motivates them. God sees all. Now, for those of us who are doing good things in the dark, that's a reason to rejoice. Amen. We're doing good, God sees it and will reward us. Have you ever done a bunch of good stuff and like, does anybody even notice? Oh yes, God sees all, that's a reason to rejoice. But if you're not doing good when nobody's watching, that's a reason to repent. It's a reason right now to turn away from what you're doing and turn back to God, because God sees what you're doing in the dark. You can fool everybody, you can fool me. Pastor, I love you, oh, everything's great. But you cannot fool God because God sees all. And the last one he invites us to celebrate over is that God is greater. That no matter what, he says that the king, through the great strength of his army, cannot save himself. The warrior, even though he has strength, and even though he has a war horse, which was, by the way, a huge technological advantage back then. The psalmist says, that won't save you. Don't trust in it. Trust in God, because God's greater. Now, he's not talking about don't have the position and don't have the war horse and don't have all that. What he's saying is don't put your trust in it, because it will fail you ultimately, but God never will, because God's greater than even the great things that we have. Now, let me tell you, Those are four reasons that you and I can rejoice from here on for the rest of our lives. God is in fact powerful, that God is in control, that God sees all and God is greater. I don't care what you're going through today, right now you have a reason to rejoice. And remember, this is not some small, yes, God is good. No, you need to get rowdy with this thing. The psalmist says, make a joyful noise. I mean, let this thing out and rejoice loudly because your God is so good to you. All right, read through Psalm 33. You know, in fact, we're at the end of it. Right after this, open up your Bible and read Psalm 33 today. That is your homework. You want to get a good grade, don't you? Do your homework. All right, that's all I got for you today. Love you. God bless you. I'll see you next time.